Another year, another new iPhone. This one's faster, has a better camera. You've heard it all before, right? But the iPhone 12 Pro is maybe a little different. Yes, it is faster and it does have a better camera, but it also brings us the first real design change in years. And more importantly, it brings up three major new features, 5G, LiDAR, and MagSafe, that maybe aren't very important right now, but it could be a big deal over time. The iPhone 12 Pro is a fantastic phone today, but it's also even more future-proof than your average iPhone. Before we talk about those new features and why they're more about the future than the present, let's talk about the stuff that's most important today. For the first time in years, Apple has dropped its curved edges for a super flat design. Flat front, flat back, flat sides. It's the same design as the iPad Pro, and it makes for a gorgeous iPhone that's really comfortable in the hand. The flat sides allows Apple to push the display a bit further toward the edges, so you get a slightly larger display in a phone body about the same size as the iPhone 11 Pro. Speaking of the body, Apple says this year's model is more durable. The IP68 water and dust resistance is improved to 30 minutes at 6 meters from 4 meters in last year's model. And a new treatment process that Apple calls ceramic shield is supposed to make it so it's harder to shatter the display. Let's talk performance. The A14 processor in the iPhone 12 Pro is the first processor made with a 5-nanometer manufacturing process. That means more logic and cache in the same size and better power efficiency. This thing flies. The CPU is 15 to 20% faster than the A13 from last year, which already smokes every other Android phone. The GPU performance is a little harder to nail down. In some graphics tests, it's the same speed as the A13, and in others, it's quite a bit faster. The bottom line is that the iPhone 12 Pro is the fastest smartphone you can buy, but you're really not going to notice much of a difference over last year's model because that phone was already so fast, it runs every app like butter. And even though the battery is slightly smaller than the one in the iPhone 11 Pro, Apple's able to squeeze a little bit more battery life out of it. That is, unless you're using 5G networking a lot. We'll have more on that in a minute. Oh, and I should mention that the starting storage size is now 128 gigabytes instead of 64. That seems appropriate for a $1,000 phone. The camera has a few nice new tricks too. It's got essentially the same camera hardware as the iPhone 11 Pro, with the same 12 megapixel wide, ultra wide, and telephoto cameras on the back, and the improved 12 megapixel true depth camera on the front. The wide camera has a new lens with a slightly wider aperture, but that's all. What's new is the software and image processing. There's a new Smart HDR 3 feature that recognizes scenes to apply post-processing differently to different parts of an image. The Deep Fusion technology now works on all cameras, not just the wide angle, and night mode now works on all the cameras except the telephoto. Coming later this year is a new Apple Pro RAW image format that aims to give professionals greater creative control, but since it's not out yet, we haven't tested it. When it comes to shooting video, the iPhone is head and shoulders above any other smartphone. You can now even shoot 10-bit Dolby Vision HDR video at up to 4K at 60 frames per second. So, thanks to better image processing, you'll get better shots more consistently with essentially the same camera hardware as last year's iPhone. There is one bit of new camera hardware, and that's a LiDAR sensor. It shoots beams of infrared light and then measures how long it takes them to reflect back in order to accurately gauge depth. It's like sonar, except with light instead of sound. In terms of camera features, it doesn't do much right now. You get faster and more accurate focus in dark scenes, and you can use night mode and portrait mode at the same time, but the real benefit of LiDAR is for augmented reality apps. With LiDAR, AR apps instantly build their 3D environment. There's no waving around the phone first. And it's way more accurate too. This is one of those features that doesn't matter much right now, but could be a big deal in the future. AR apps just don't seem to have caught on yet, but that's partially because they're not a very good experience without something like LiDAR. For now, LiDAR is kind of nice to have, but maybe in a couple of years, there'll be some really killer AR apps and you'll be really glad you have a LiDAR-equipped iPhone. 5G is another feature like that. All of this year's iPhone 12 models support 5G, and no matter what your carrier, at least here in the US, you get full 5G support across the spectrum, including those really short range but really fast millimeter wave frequencies. It appears to work really well if you can actually get a 5G signal. Carriers just haven't built out their networks enough yet to make a big difference in your day-to-day use. If you plan to still have this phone in a couple years, you'll be really glad it has 5G support, because by then, 5G will be everywhere and it'll be much faster than 4G LTE. 5G is a bit of a battery drain though. Apple has an auto 5G mode that connects to 5G only when it's going to make a difference, and then the rest of the time drops back to LTE to save battery. It's too early to know really how well this works, but just know that if you're on 5G a lot, your battery isn't going to last as long. There is one more big new feature, and like 5G and LiDAR, it's really not that beneficial yet. Apple calls it MagSafe. It's taking the name from the old magnetic charging cables that MacBooks used to have. On the iPhone 12 and presumably future iPhones, MagSafe is a combination of a faster Qi wireless charging coil, NFC, and a ring of magnets right in the middle of the back of the phone. The idea is to let you magnetically snap on all sorts of accessories and to boost wireless charging performance up from 7.5 watts to 15. Now don't worry, all your old Qi wireless chargers will still work just fine. You'll only get the faster performance when you use MagSafe. Apple's first MagSafe accessories are kind of a flop though. The MagSafe cases are just cases. They don't do anything special except let you stack other MagSafe accessories onto them. And the MagSafe charger is a $40 puck that's too small and light to be a good wireless charging pad. When you pick up your iPhone, the charger will come right off the desk with it. And the cable is too short to use your phone while you charge it. But MagSafe is loaded with possibilities, from floating charging stands or articulating mounts, or car mounts, or even just new ways to attach things like camera lenses. It's just going to take some time for all the accessory makers to start making some cool MagSafe stuff. In a year or two, you're gonna probably wish that your iPhone had MagSafe, just like you're gonna wish it had 5G or LiDAR. See what I mean when I say the iPhone 12 Pro is a little more future-proof? Yeah, it's faster, it has a better camera and more storage, and all that stuff is great, but its most significant new features are more about what they can do for you in a year than what they can do for you today. Does that mean you shouldn't buy one? Well, it still starts at $999 despite all these improvements over the iPhone 11 Pro, but the regular iPhone 12, the non-Pro model, gives you almost all this same stuff except for the telephoto lens and LiDAR, and it costs more than $100 less even if you get the 128GB model. Or if you're really into photography, the larger and more expensive iPhone 12 Pro Max is about to come out, and it's got a new larger sensor with sensor shift image stabilization. It's hard to knock the value here though. For the same price as last year's Pro, you get an even faster processor, slightly larger display, improved cameras, 5G, LiDAR, MagSafe, and improved durability. If you're buying an iPhone for today, it's a very good choice. If you're buying an iPhone for the future, it's an even better one.